bathroom. The, when we say women's bathroom, there's no women inmates in the Southern Correct, Southern State, are there?
No.
Right, so it's the women's bathroom for visitors, right? Or for female, are there
females.
Employees would also use that bathroom?
Yes.
All right, and you testified that an inmate came to you and told you that there were drugs in like the light fixture in the bathroom?
Yes, the light switch was pretty. There was over the light switch. It was an empty hollow space. It's had a plate over it.
So it's like all outlets or switches have a wall plate. You're saying it's like you took out the screws, it's behind the wall plate?
Yes.
And you said that after the inmate told you that, you didn't actually go in the bathroom.
No, I didn't.
And you didn't actually go in and remove the drugs from the wall plate.
No.
No. And you also didn't write a report, did you?
No.
Okay. And that's different than what you said with John Small, but I'll get to that in a little bit. Before becoming a corrections officer, you went to academy, right?
Yes.
And that's a corrections officer academy?
Yes.
And while you're there, you're trained on what your duties and responsibilities are as a corrections officer, right?
Yes.
What are your duties and responsibilities as a corrections officer?
Duties are secure, make sure safety, make sure everybody pretty much follow rules and regulations and go home.
Right, and you actually sign an oath of office that you're going to uphold the standards and regulations of the New Jersey Department of Corrections, right?
Yes.
So, isn't one of the things you're supposed to do is make sure there's no contraband in the prison?
Yes.
And you're supposed to make sure that there's no drugs lying around in the prison, right?
Yes.
So when you found them, you just left them there and went and told the supervisor?
That's not what happened.
You said you didn't go in the bathroom, right? Did you go in the bathroom?
No, I didn't want
right, so you didn't go in the bathroom, and you found the supervisor. Where'd you go to find a supervisor?
Supervisor came around to the unit.
Supervisor came around to the unit, so you called the supervisor?
Yes, he was on his way over to the supervisor, made what you call rounds.
Right, so you didn't actually call him. He was just happened to be coming your way.
He was on his way over.
So if he didn't come, who knows when you would have reported it, right?
No, I want to report it.
You, in your mind, you were going to?
No, right? I was going to report it.
Okay, but you didn't actually write a report, did you?
No, we did not write a report.
And that's one of the things that you're supposed to do, right, as a corrections officer, write reports?
I'm supposed to let my supervisor know, and what my supervisor does from there, we follow.
Right, and so you don't, sometimes you write reports, sometimes you don't?
Let our supervisor know, and from what he tells us to do, that's what we do.
Okay. All right, I'm going to talk to you about, you said you were going on vacation. You talked a lot about going on vacation. We heard a lot of testimony about you going on vacation, right?
Yes.
And you were asked about some vacation slips that you filled out.
Yes.
All right, I'm gonna show you, because these are all individually numbered. I'm gonna show you first what's been numbered as D9. Can you take a look at D9 for me?
Yes.
All right. Could you publish that to the jury? It's 11:22, I believe. Does it say it's from 11:22? All right. That vacation time was not actually approved, was it?
No, it wasn't.
All right. Did you know that several of those leave slips that you submitted, the vacation time was not approved?
Yes.
All right. So, in your mind again, in your mind, you're going on vacation, but it hasn't actually been approved by the Department of Corrections.
It hasn't been approved.
Right. And just so we're clear, isn't it true with your vacation slip you submitted for 11:28? That was also not approved.
Correct.
11:28. So it's also not approved. And for 11:24, that's also not approved, right?
Yes.
So you're just going to leave and not show up?
No.
Well, you said you're going on vacation. You supposedly booked this trip to New Orleans, but you didn't actually have accrued vacation time?
No. The vacation days I put in was to get the days. I also have what you call sick days and personal days.
We don't have any of those slips, though, do we?
No, you don't need a slip for a sick day or a personal day.
So you were just planning that you're going to take a sick day, even though it wasn't accrued. Before, you're like, I'm going to go for a week, I don't have vacation, and then I'll just take sick days after I get back.
No.
Then I won't know where I was.
No. I sat here and filled out the slip. See what days I was going to get approved off. The days that wasn't approved, I'm going to call as far as the sick time.
All right, so you're going to call from New Orleans to say you were sick.
As far as the 22nd, no, I sobered at home.
All right, but what is it, 11:28?
11:28.
Right. So you'd be calling in from New Orleans, vacation, to say you were sick?
Now I've been back. I've been back from New Orleans.
Didn't you tell Tasha Swain that you weren't going to be back until December 1st?
Yes.
All right. That you weren't going back on duty until December 1st?
Yes.
But now you're saying that you were going to be back before December 1st.
I was going to be back from New Orleans before the 28th. I was not going back to work.
You were going to be
in
sick
my
on
unit until
because you decided you're going to be sick on the 28th.
Now
right.
I decided I'm going to be sick on the 28th.
Well,
I'm going to call in sick on the 28th.
Right. You're going to call in sick on the 28th?
Yes.
Whether you were or not?
Yes.
Okay. And what does it really have to do with anything then that you were going on vacation? Right? Because Tasha Swain knew that you weren't going to be bringing in anything until December 1st. That's what you told the detective during the interview, didn't you?
Can I talk about objective questions? Confusing. What does that have to do with anything?
I don't know if it's confusing to you, Mr. Saunders.
The question that he asked me.
No, that question.
Oh, that question? Can you repeat the question again, please?
What difference does it make if you're going on vacation? You told Tasha Swain that you weren't going to be bringing in until December 1st.
I never told Tasha I was bringing in anything December 1st.
Well, you told the detectives. What you said was, my plan was to sit there, and what I was going to do, I was going to sit there and see if I could actually find somebody to be like, this is what I need you to do, or whatever.
I don't object. It's not the proper way to do this for prosecutor to read a statement. He wants to use it to impeach. He wouldn't do that. It's not the way.
He can't quote the statement?
No.
Why
not? Like that. Well, I just find the software doesn't show.
It's not, it's just before, is it a hearsay objection? Because it's not hearsay. It's already played before.
It's not hearsay. It's just not the way to do it. Now I can explain.
I wouldn't go sign.